Hello everybody, today we are going to see some examples which are depend on the volume of sphere. Okay, so see here, first example is the volume of the two spheres are in the ratio 64:27. Find the difference of their surface areas if sum of their radii is 7. Okay, sum of the radii is 7. What is given? See, first, the volume of the two spheres are in the ratio 64:27. So, first we will consider here volume of two spheres B, V1 and V2 respectively. Okay, and radius we will consider radii of two spheres B, R1 and R2 respectively. Okay, volume is V1 and V2, radius is R1 and R2. Okay, means R1 is the radius of V1 and R2 is radius for V2. Okay, so what is given here? See, the volume of the two spheres are in the ratio 64:27. So, V1 upon V2 is equal to 64:27. Okay, volume 1 upon volume 2 is equal to 64:27. That ratio is given. Okay, now we know that the volume of sphere we use 4 by 3 pi r1 cube. Okay, and volume V2 means volume 2, 4 by 3 pi r2 cube is equal to 64:27. Okay, only here radius is different. Here radius is R1 and here radius is R2. Okay, so now here common factors 4 by 3 will be cancelled and pi will be cancelled. So what is remaining here now? R1 upon R1 cube upon R2 cube. R1 cube upon R2 cube is equal to 64:27. Okay, and we know that 64 and 27 are the perfect cubes. So we can write that R1 cube upon R2 cube is equal to, this is 4 cube and this is 3 cube. 27 is the cube of 3. Okay, so now if you cancel cubes of both the sides, then what you will get? R1 upon R2 is equal to 4:3. R1 upon R2 is equal to 4/3. Okay, so radius R1 and R2 we got 4/3. So with the help of this, we can write R1 is equal to 4/3 into R2. R1 is equal to 4/3 into R2. Okay. Now what is given? See, after this, it is given that find the difference of their surface areas. We have to find out surface areas. If the sum of their radii is 7, sum of the radii is given 7. So R1 plus R2 is given 7. Sum of the radius, both the radius R1 plus R2 is given 7. So R1 is equal to what? 4/3 into R2. R1 is equal to 4/3 into R2 plus this R2 is equal to 7. Okay. So now here we can write 4R2 plus 3 into R2, 3R2, and this 3 we need to take here, 7 threes are 21. Okay, 4 into R2, 4R2 plus this R2 into 3, 3R2 is equal to 7 threes are 21. Okay, so now here 4 plus 3, 7R2 is equal to 21. So R2 is equal to 21/7. So that is 7 threes are 21. Okay, so R2 is equal to 3 centimeters. R2 is equal to 3 centimeters. Okay, so now we can find out R1. R1 plus R2 is equal to 7. So R2 is 3 centimeters. Suppose I will put here in equation R1 plus this 3 is equal to 7. So R1 is equal to 7 minus 3, that is 4 centimeters. So R1 is 4 centimeter, R2 is 3 centimeter. Okay. Now we have to find out the difference of their surface area. Surface area is, what is the formula of surface area? 4 pi r square. So here we will take difference of the surface areas. Difference of surface areas is equal to 4 pi R1 square minus 4 pi R2 square. Okay, 4 pi r1 square minus 4 pi r2 square. Here we can take 4 pi common. That is what is going to remain here, r1 square minus r2 square. So 4 pi into r1. What is r1? R1 is 4 centimeter. R1 is 4 centimeter. So 4 square minus r2 is 3. So 3 square. So 4 multiply by 22 by 7 multiply by 4 square is 16. 16 minus 3 square is 9. So 4 multiply by 27 upon 22 by 7 multiply by 16 minus 9 is 7. Okay, so this 7 will be cancelled. 22 fours are 88 centimeter square. So that is the difference of their surface areas. Okay, so once again see carefully what was given. The volume of the two spheres are in the ratio 64:27. So volume we have taken V1 and V2. So ratio was given 64:27. So we have taken 64/27. So what is the formula of volume of sphere? 4 by 3 pi r1 cube. R1 is the radius of first sphere and r2 is the radius of second sphere. Formulas will be same. So 4 by 3 pi r1 cube and divided by 4 by 3 pi r2 cube. Okay, is equal to 64/7. So common factor will be deleted. So now what is remaining? R1 cube upon R2 cube. So 64 and 27 are the perfect cubes, 4 cube and 3 cube. So we have taken, when you will cancel cubes of both the sides, so R1 upon R2 is equal to 4/3. So R1 is equals to 4/3 multiplied by R2. Why we have taken this? Because they have told us sum of their radii is 7. So R1 plus R2 is equal to 7. Okay, so R1 plus R2, what is the R1? R1 is equal to 4/3 R2. Okay, suppose here we will say first, and here we need to write from 1. Okay, so 4/3 R2 plus R2 is equal to 7. When you will solve, that time you will get R2 is equal to 3 centimeter. You can put this value of R2 in equation, then you will get value of R1. Okay, we have to find out the difference of their surface area. Surface area formula is 4 pi r1 square minus 4 pi r2 square. Okay, so here we have taken 4 pi common, r1 square minus r2 square. R1 is 4 square and r2 is 3 square. So 4 multiplied by 22 by 7 into 16 minus 9 is 7. So 7 will be cancelled. 22 fours are 88 centimeter square is the correct answer. Okay. Our second problem is find the volume and the total surface area of hemisphere of radius 3.5 centimeter. Okay, value of pi is given. Once again I am reading this, see, find the volume and the total surface area. Two things here we need to find out, volume and total surface area of hemisphere is there, of radius 3.5 centimeter. Radius is given 3.5 centimeter. And hemisphere is there. So very simple question, directly we can find out. So here see, radius we will use r, that is 3.5 centimeter, this is given. Okay, now volume of hemisphere is equals to 2/3 half of the volume of sphere 2/3 pi r cube. So that is 2/3 into 22/7 into r cube. R cube is, r is 3.5. So here we can take 3.5 multiply by 3.5 into 3.5 centimeter cube. Okay, so now here finally we can do here 7 ones are 7, 7 5s are 35. Okay, 7 5s are 35. Now we can write here, we need to do this product. 22 5s are 110. Okay, after one digit decimal point, so 11 2s are 22 multiply by 3.5 into 3.5 divided by 3. Okay, 22 multiply by 3.5 into 3.5. okay, so this product is 269.5 divided by 3. 269.5 divided by 3. So here you can write 3 8s are 24, 9s are 27.83 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of hemisphere. Okay, very simple question. Formula directly we have to use. radius is given directly, so just we have to put the values and then you will get the answer. Okay, now second thing they are asking, surface area of the sphere. Surface area means total surface area. So what is total surface area? Curved surface area is 2 pi r square, and total surface area means we need to include the top area. So 2 pi r square plus pi r square, so that will be 3 pi r square. So total surface area TSA, total surface area of hemisphere is equal to 3 pi r square. So 3 multiply by pi is 22/7, radius is 3.5 into 3.5 centimeter square. Okay, so now here again 7 5 is 35, 22 5 is 110, 11 3 is 33 multiply by 3.5 centimeter square. So 33 multiply by 3.5 is equal to 115.5 centimeter square. Okay, so this is the total surface area of the sphere. So directly we have taken the formula, and directly when you will put the values, you will get the answer. Okay, so this is very simple question. Such type of questions can come for 2 marks. This is for 1 mark and this is for 1 mark. Okay, so here really directly based on the concept. So directly radius was given, just we have to put the values and you will get the answer. Okay. Okay, our third problem is a solid sphere of radius 3 cm is melted and then cast into small spherical balls, each of diameter 0.6 cm. Find the number of balls thus obtained. Okay, so this is the question. So now here we need to think about, see, a solid sphere of radius 3 cm. There is a solid sphere whose radius is 3 cm. Radius is 3 cm. Okay, it is melted, means this is definitely related to the volume. It is melted and then recast into small spherical balls. Okay, then recast into small spherical balls. Okay, how many balls? That is not given. Okay, each of diameter 0.6 cm, whose diameter is 0.6 cm, diameter is given. Okay, so find the number of balls thus obtained. So here we have to find out how many balls you will get from this. That number of balls we have to find out. Okay, so here first we must know the volume of this. Okay, first we will decide the flow of this. Very simple, volume of the sphere whose radius is 3 cm. Okay, then we will find out volume of sphere whose radius is 0.6 divided by 2, that is diameter is given 0.6. So once you will get both the volumes, that time what we have to do, we have to divide this volume by the volume of small spherical ball, then you will get number of balls automatically. Okay, so first we will find out volume of sphere. So radius is given, volume of sphere whose radius is 3 cm. Radius is equals to 3 cm. Okay, so volume is equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube, 4 by 3 into pi r cube. Okay, so now here 4 by 3 multiply by pi, I am keeping as it is because finally we are going to divide. So definitely 5 pi we can cancel. So pi into radius is 3 cm. So 3 into 3 cm cube. Okay, so now here this 3 and this 3 will be cancelled. So what is remaining here? 3 3s are 9, 9 4s are 36. 36 pi cm cube. This is the volume of this big sphere. Okay, now we will find out volume of this sphere, volume of small ball, spherical ball. Okay, so for that radius of ball is equals to, what is radius of ball? Diameter is given 0.6. okay, diameter is given 0.6, so radius will be 0.6 divided by 2, so that is 0.3, 0.6 divided by 2, 0.3, okay. So volume of spherical ball, volume of spherical ball is equals to again 4 by 3 pi r cube, r cube means this 0.3, okay. So 4 by 3 pi r cube, so that is again 4 upon 3 into pi into r. What is r? 0.3, 0.3 we can write 3 by 10 into 3 by 10 into 3 by 10, okay. So now this here we can cancel this 3, okay. So what is remaining here? See, 4 3s are 12, 12 3s are 36, 36 pi, 36 pi upon 10, 10s are 100, 100 10s are 1000, 36 pi upon 1000. Okay, so this is volume of spherical ball. This is the volume of spherical ball. This is volume of sphere and this is volume of spherical ball. Okay, so now here we have to find out number of balls. How many balls you will get? So what you will do? Volume of this sphere, big sphere divided by volume of this. Okay, so that number of balls we will take x, number of balls b x, number of ball b x. Okay, so what we can do here? Here this is the volume of one spherical ball. How many balls are there? That we don't know. So here this we will multiply by x. So 36 pi upon 1000 multiply by x is equals to this volume, 36 pi. Okay, so here we can find out x, this we can take that side and we can divide. So x is equals to 36 pi multiply by 1000 divided by 36 pi. Okay, this will go that side and we need to multiply with this reciprocal. So what is 36 pi and this 36 pi will be cancelled. So answer is 1000 spherical balls. 1000 spherical balls you will get after melting. Understood? Once again, see here what we have done. One spherical ball was given, a sphere of radius 3 cm. This is the sphere of radius 3 cm. It is melted. So first here we have to find out volume of that sphere. Okay, so that we got 36 pi centimeter square. Then we have to find out volume of small spherical ball. Okay, so that is radius we need to find out. So radius is 0.3. Volume of spherical ball is equal to again the same formula, only radius is different. So 4 by 3 into pi, radius 0.3. So we can write 3 by 10. So that way we have taken 3 will be cancelled, 36 by 1000. Directly also we can divide, or we can take number of balls be x. So 36 pi by 1000, this is the volume of small spherical ball, multiply by number of balls is equal to volume, because finally volume is going to be same. So that way we have done, and x is equal to 1000, that is number of balls are 1000. Okay.